Hello everyone. Today I'll demonstrate the process of signal debugging for this roundtable interactive projection. Currently, we have the system debugged and ready. Press the spacebar to enter the debugging mode. If it's a table that has never been debugged, press the X key to reset all parameters and follow the second step as prompted on the desktop. At this point, use the mouse scroll wheel to zoom the size of the yellow circle, which corresponds to our desktop image. Align the circle with our desktop as closely as possible using the mouse drag and scroll wheel. One thing to note is that after initially aligning the image, our depth camera will not be aligned. For instance, if I place my hand here, the image will be misaligned. To align the depth image, the first step is to find the horizontal centerline of the table. The red line represents the horizontal centerline of the table's image. Place several reflective points along the horizontal centerline. These reflective points are made of fully reflective fabric. Such materials appear very bright in visible light images and are beyond the effective depth range in depth camera images. You can see the orange dots on the screen representing each reflective point's position. After placing them, press the B key. It will to automatically calculate and save the horizontal position of the table in the current depth camera image, shown by the dark line. Press the B key again to return to the debugging process. Next, move the reflective points to the blue dots on the screen, a total of 6 positions. After placing them, press any key from 0 to 5 to enter the depth image correction mode. Press the corresponding number keys to control and correct the position of the points. Please pay attention here. We start by correcting points 4 and 5 on the horizontal line. In the first correction round, just adjust roughly. Accuracy is not required. 1. 2. 3. Then repeat the adjustment for points 4 and 5. And in the second round, adjust more precisely. 1, 2, 3. After aligning the points, place your hand on the table again and see that the green depth camera image matches the position of your hand. Next, check if the depth values read by the camera are consistent for the same object at different height positions on the screen. Since our depth camera is installed at an angle, there will be a depth difference. Place a solid object at the lower position on the central axis and note the value. For example, around 36 to 37. This is the height difference between it and the desktop. Then move it to the upper position on the central axis and note the value again, which will be larger. The lower value is too small. Now, we need to adjust this depth difference and increase the ratio T value by pressing the T key. Lowercase T key to increase this value. As you increase this value, the depth value read by the camera will increase. It's around 38 now. Now put it on top. It is also adjusted around 38. Values at a distance are less stable, so we've set this up. press the number 6 key. Back to our debugging process. After that, set the minimum effective depth threshold value. The current value displayed on the screen is 12 millimeters, meaning an object needs to be at least about 1 centimeter above the table to be recognized. This value should not be too small. A value too small will cause noise, while too large will reduce sensitivity. Adjust to a suitable level. Adjust this value using the left and right brackets. You can see if we make it smaller, there's a lot more noise in the distance. That's actually inappropriate. Let's make it bigger. Generally around 10 to 12 millimeters is suitable. Then the next parameter. Set the minimum number of points required for recognizing a stable tracking point. Here we set it at 20. We can use the greater than and less than these two keys to adjust. Adjust as needed. Too small a value causes interference signals. Too large reduces sensitivity. Next step, we need to record the feature parameters of the objects to be recognized, such as cups and plates. Press Z and follow the on-screen instructions to place a cup in the center. Use the arrow keys to define the size and range of the object's edge. Press the up and down keys to control the inner blue circle, which is roughly a range where its edges are located. Then press the left and right keys to control a range of sizes of its edges. It's important to adjust to a point where the outer yellow circle completely covers the object's depth image, and the inner yellow circle leaves a certain range to mark the middle empty space. This facilitates real-time depth recognition of the middle part later on. For example, triggering effects when pouring drinks. After adjusting the range, press I multiple times to record the current height and range of the object. After adjustment, then remove the cup and press Z again to repeat the process for a plate. The up, down, left, and right keys circle its edge range. Then press the A button repeatedly. Record its height eigenvalue. Adjustment for this step. The goal during this process is to achieve a clear distinction between the objects being recognized. Next to the object, there are two fractional values, SM and BG. The ideal state is when adjusting for the first object. For example, the cup, the SM score should stabilize around 120. For the second object, for example, the plate, you need to perform a similar adjustment. But the previous one is set with the exact opposite value. When recording the plate's parameters, the BG score should stabilize around 120. Conversely, the SM score should be close to zero. Then press the Z key again. Back to the debugging process. Next, we need to adjust the position of object recognition. Due to the fact that an object has a certain height, when it is placed on the table, its actual position is shifted to a certain extent. We can put different objects on the table. Adjust the recognized position of objects using the arrow keys. The green dot represents the object's signal position, while the pink and yellow dots are the correction positions. Use the arrow up and down keys on the keyboard adjust to align the correction position with the object. As we press the button, we can see it's automatically changing. And then, when it's basically aligned, we put them in different places. Check again that this position is aligned correctly. Okay. Finally, clear the table of all items and the reflective points. Then the debugging is done. And press the spacebar to return to the interactive mode. Test to ensure the responses are accurate and the positions correct. Butterflies are also very responsive. The positional correspondence is also correct. Place a cup or plate to see the reaction. Okay. Then the plate will trigger a butterfly to fly around it. So our debugging is all finished. Okay.